A mystery in the mailbox. A local woman started receiving piles of mail at her house, all addressed to her deceased father.
So News 4 Investigates took the issue directly to the post office to ask why. Our Lauren Traeger says it happened to the wife of a News 4 employee, and it could affect you when a loved one passes on.
Yeah, just no one was prepared.
It's been 2 years since Debbie Perrin lost her dad, Robert Jones, a Marine vet, a doting grandfather and great-grandfather.
He's really generous with his time, and he was really just a good friend.
But while she'll never forget him, she's tried to heal. What's making it harder? The daily trip to the mailbox and what she finds inside. An ever-growing box of mail addressed directly to her dad.
It's a tough reminder. It gets to be a little creepy. Feels a little creepy sometimes.
Debbie's got a deluge of mailers.
It wasn't like old mail, it was new mail. That's for cable.
Most of it complete junk.
Car insurance. You got a Christmas card from a business that's for more cable.
Seeing his name is pretty painful.
We got a welcome package, welcome to the neighborhood, which was probably the hardest packet to read.
She didn't ask for any of it.
Wish I didn't have to look at it every day.
150,000 pieces of mail a day.
We took Debbie's concerns here to the main post office in St. Louis.
So here is all the mail that has come in that needs to be forwarded.
Here's the issue. When Robert died, Debbie requested that his mail be forwarded to her house so she could take care of his affairs. There's no option to tell the post office he's deceased. So for several months, his regular mail was forwarded as expected. But then it started to turn into the junk, coming addressed directly to Robert Jones and even to Debbie's mom at Debbie's address. How does that happen? It turns out the post office sells that address forwarding information to its customers.
We have consumers who pay for that information, and the post office provides that information to that company.
So it's assumed that her address is his new permanent address, and the junk mail floodgates open. There's a simple way to have prevented the problem, Kimberly Cardwell Harley says. Someone in Debbie's position should select the option to only temporarily forward the mail. But Debbie thinks the post office should do things differently.
Well, it be to their benefit. I think they should be a little bit more clear as if there are options. You know, we didn't know if there were options.
For now, the junk mail just keeps coming.
Somebody's spending money and wasting money at the same time.
Targeted at someone who certainly no longer needs it.
This is very inefficient, he would say. This is a waste. This is really not good.
Unfortunately, there's not a lot Debbie can do now except contact the individual advertisers. But she's tried writing deceased on some of the mail and returning it to sender, but it still hasn't stopped. We'll keep pressing the post office for answers on how to prevent this. In the meantime, do you have something you'd like us to investigate? You can email us at investigates@kmov.com. Lauren Traeger, News 4 Investigates.